boy, Shant, and your boy, Redacted.
What's going on? Catch us on Wylion Mofo, Real Dumbshit, and Redacted Shant for the Twitter. On YouTube and on Facebook is Official Wylion. Instagram is Wylion Official. And Mixcloud is Wylion RDS for all that dumb shit.
What's going on? From the darkest minds and the strangest places, I am the one that they call Shant, and he is the one that is called
Redacted.
And we are here today with that real dumbness. Starting off with The Darkest Minds, Negan and Tekken, Kidding, featuring Jim Carrey, Meg, Purge, the TV series, Green Book, New Oscars versus Old Oscars, Star Wars, Grant and Ruby's Instagram Shutdown, Eco, The Warrior, and Gareth Evans and Apostle, which is coming on Netflix. So, just to give it a quick sort of like easy in, what's the dumb shit? Mr. Redacted.
You're asking me?
Yeah, I'm just saying, anything dumb happen?
Oh. Nah, not really.
Nah, okay, cool. So, straight on with the show.
Not this time, motherfucker.
Okay, fine. I just get out of the way before I'm rudely interrupted.
You'll never know when you're going to get rudely interrupted.
Great stuff.
That's how this shit works.
So, The Darkest Minds. A lot of people, I mean, I've seen it. If you haven't seen it, just skip the next 5 minutes, even though, yeah, you've had time. So 5 minutes into
I say don't skip it, because just skip the film.
Yeah, actually, I'm probably saving you a lot of time. It's about 2 hours of your life that you probably won't get back constructively. Darkest Minds, for those that aren't in the know, is written by Stranger Things. In a nutshell...
They wrote the screenplay, though.
They didn't write the book. So, in regards to sort of like that whole structure...
Also, Stranger Things is a show. Shows can't write.
I know. Saying like people that wrote it. It's fine. Either, right? Stranger Things is great. Darkest Minds, not so great.
Yeah. I mean, look, if you're adapting a screenplay, there's only so much you can do with garbage.
Yeah.
Like, if the book's garbage, there's only so much you can do.
I mean, in a nutshell, all I can say is that it's like if Children of Men and the Runaways, Marvel's Runaways, had a baby, then that baby was born in the same time with the girl with the gifts, and then it then got made into a color-coded system, you got Darkest Minds. So, in loosely, you know, layman's terms, a girl gets taken from her home, and then she gets taken to a camp where she is labelled and identified as an orange. Using her orange abilities, she then erases the person's minds to say, no, I am a yellow or green or something like that. Yellow and green are different abilities, different scales of ability. So if you imagine orange being a psychic, super psychic, yellow being sort of like... able to use telepathy, green being super genius, and then the last one is actually there's two more. There's like blue, which is like person that can control electricity, and then red, which is basically fire breathing humans that obey government demands. So it's weird. But yeah, in a nutshell, I mean, X-Men was bad, the first one I'm talking about. This is better than the first X-Men as such as... But it's not better than. So, it's... Meh. I'm very meh about the film.
I mean, it looks like that was the point. Like, they... From the trailer, they weren't trying to make a good movie. They were trying to make a meh movie.
Yeah, I mean, like, it's good if you've got popcorn and you've got a lady friend round and you don't really want to miss something good.
Oh, you mean
background music?
Netflix and chill this. Exactly, not even.
Netflix has now become a sophisticated, selfish act. Well, personally, I'm not saying, you know, that is for everybody, but yeah. So, Darkest Minds, if I was to give it any stars, any ratings out of 10, I wouldn't, because, you know, you can't go into minuses, so...
Okay, minus 8 stars.
Minus 8 stars, yeah. Only because of the interview that I saw on Screen Junkies. So, yeah, I mean, you're smart enough, you can check it out yourselves. But yeah, that's that one. Negan in Tekken.
Yeah.
Personally, I like the fact that The Walking Dead are getting into other games or gaming genres other than the Telltale series and using the actual character properties. However, I am strongly... I'm not against it, because I still want to play with the character, because I think it's badass.
Sounds like you're against it.
Huh?
Sounds like you're against it.
I am, on the purpose of continuity and logic. Tekken is crazy enough as it is. And you've got, you know, two feuding Yakuza bosses that are, you know, king of, you know, Iron Fist or the Mishia Saibatsu, whatever. So you've got enough craziness in there. You don't need the leader of a zombie apocalypse out there thrown in on top.
It does, because fuck that game.
Bruv.
Fuck that game. I played that game around my friend's house, and like the last one.
What, 6 or 7?
I think it was 6.
Six isn't as good as 7.
Maybe it was 7.
Is that the one with
it's
the pig?
It's seven.
Yeah, 7.
So fuck that game, bruv. Fuck that game. You know why fuck that game? Right. Because when you're playing through the game, like, you're forced to watch the cutscenes.
No, that's only if you're playing the story mode.
So, sometimes I don't want to play the story mode. Like,
yeah, and then it's all about the cutscenes.
They're so long, though. Why are they so fucking long?
Because they wanted to give a...
No.
Engrossing...
No.
No,
it's too long.
Well, this is it.
It's too long. It doesn't need to be that long.
Because you've got the latter with Street Fighter 4. Street Fighter 4.
There's more cutscenes than there is playing game. Like, you might have to wait 25 minutes before I can play a match.
Yeah.
That's fucking bullshit, bruv.
Yeah.
That's bullshit.
Nah, but to be fair, with Tekken...
Even playing online is long.
Yeah?
Even playing online is long. We got to wait in a queue. Fuck that game, bruv.
Right, so I mean, but Negan's going to be added to it, so season 2 looks better. So you've got Liu Long, you've got Nina Williams, and you've got Negan. So personally, I'm a Tekken fan. I know that you hate it, so
I used to like it.
I
played 7.
I don't mind 7. I mean, like, because it's not a case of the story mode being its be all and end all. They have simplified the game. That's the only
thing. I just named two elements that were bullshit. Like, how many more? That's enough. That's too much.
But I do I do like the addition of the rage art. I believe it's about time that they had something.
It's a bit bullshit, though, isn't it?
Yeah, but it's the same thing when it was introducing Soul Calibur. So
yeah, but it doesn't mean it's a good idea.
Yeah, but it's one of those ones where if you're online, it's very annoying, actually. But then saying that, I play Street Fighter, where you can, you know, turn everything around with a super move. So. Yeah, it is where it is. Alright, so, Negan, the character, anyway, I believe a baseball bat character is a good addition in some senses, because it's something new. I mean, fair enough, you've got a guy with a sword, which I always thought was a bit unfair in Tekken. You know, a guy running.
If there's a guy that turns into a fucking demon, like, how can you say a guy with a sword is unfair?
Because there's a guy that turns into a demon, and there's a guy with a sword, and there's people that use their fists.
Yeah, so it's all unfair. The whole game is unbalanced.
Yeah, it's crazy. But yeah, it's fun. It's fun to play. Moving on. Kidding. HBO have basically... it's not HBO, it's Showtime, I believe.
Okay.
Have done the Mr. Rogers TV show, or they're doing a TV show, Mr. Kerry, which is obviously a bit left field because he is a quote-unquote movie star, and it's his first kind of like TV project, I would say. So, Kidding, what's your verdict on that?
What, is it Mr. Rogers?
Yeah, he's portraying Mr. Rogers.
So it'd be like the same as Mr. Rogers?
No, it's kind of like the same as Man in the Moon.
So he was playing the actor?
He's playing the actor, yeah. Mr. Rogers. He's not playing the actor of Mr. Rogers, he's playing the human who is Mr. Rogers.
So he's playing the character Mr. Rogers?
No, He's playing the guy that played. Yeah, so he's playing his life, basically.
Not interested.
Why?
The film just came out about Mr. Rogers. Like, well, you don't need a TV series as well.
No, but it's like a HBO thing.
Doesn't matter.
No, I mean,
Showtime, man, it doesn't matter. Like, the film just came out. Actually, apparently, it was very good.
Like,
I don't also need a TV.
No, it's not. It's not. It's not a film. It's a documentary that's come out.
A documentary is a film.
No, no, no. We've been through this before.
Whatever. Yeah, a documentary film. This just came out.
This is a dramatization. Well, dramatization series, which is coming out.
Yeah,
and this is what spurred on the documentary.
Not interested.
I am. Meg.
Nah, just watch the documentary. You'll save yourself like 18 hours.
No,
you will.
No, we'll not save any time.
How many episodes is the TV series?
That's a good question. I think it is. Let's fill this up. I think it is. Showtime, it's probably about 12.
Right, you'll save yourself 10.5 hours at least if you just watch the film.
Yeah,
or sorry, the documentary.
Right, on to the Meg, anyway. Moving on to the Meg.
Why are you hating?
I'm not hating, I'm just saying Jim Carrey is a great actor, give it a chance. The Meg is trying
to... No, just put him in something interesting.
He is in something interesting.
What, Mr. Rogers?
Yeah. The guy is an interesting character. Who does that? That isn't a paedophile, sort of thing. I'm just saying, because I am from the UK, and all my heroes are dead. Rolf Harris, Jimmy Savile.
Optimus Prime.
Optimus Prime. Touching kids everywhere. Everyone apart from Lino.
He's dead now.
Lino?
Yeah.
How come?
From the Castle.
Yeah, he died. So the Meg, anyway.
No heroes left.
No heroes.
So the Meg, yeah, I want to see it.
I do as well. Looks very, very familiar to most of my nightmares as a child.
Great.
Big shark.
Great.
Swimming in the water.
Yep.
Biting people to death.
Yep, it's the nightmare you have after you watch Jaws.
That's great. Great. No more cheese before bed.
Yeah.
Pretty much. But it looks good. Jason Statham, you know.
Jason Statham's. Jason Statham's.
Statham's. I'm so surprised he hasn't released like a steakhouse. Statham Steaks. You know, like.
It's too serious for that shit.
It's crazy. Not really. I mean, I've seen him in a couple of goofy roles. Have you ever seen...
What?
What's that? A Mean Machine.
That's not really... He wasn't goofy in that.
Yeah, he's absolutely fucking mental.
Yeah, but he's not goofy.
Fair enough. Played absolute nutter, didn't he?
Yeah.
Was it... What's that one where he's shocking himself and trying to keep alive?
It is not... Chevchelios.
Yeah?
Chevchelios, isn't it? That's his character's name.
Yes, his name, Chevchelios.
It's, God, why can't I remember what that's called? Anyway, it's not goofy.
There's a sequel. I think that's the only one he's done a sequel to.
It's not goofy.
Oh, apart from,
Expendables.
What's that?
He's done lots. Expendables, Transporter, yeah. Mechanic. He does fucking, sequels to everything.
The Mechanic is like a sequel to the Transporter, right?
No.
It feels that way.
Yeah, because
it's
they wanted something with that vibe. I don't think it is. It's but like it's
a
called hitman. The Mechanic. Yeah, he's a hitman. But,
it's always a fucking hitman.
What I was saying was, that film is not... It's not goofy. Like, it's... comic booky, sort of. But,
yeah.
Like, extreme kind of like... like, Image Vertigo type of comic booky. But it's not goofy. Like, he's still a serious character, even though, like, outlandish shit happens in the film.
I suppose.
Even, like, Spy. Like, the character in Spy is a comedy, but, like, he's serious in that film. Like, he's serious and over the top, like, over the top as, like, a, you know, like crazy
yeah.
CIA or whatever type guy.
Extreme. Yeah. I would say extreme's about
yeah, extreme. But he doesn't really do that. He doesn't really do goofy.
What's that guy that was in Coronation Street and then he went into Rambo and then we never saw him again?
Fuck it, Rambo?
Yeah, the singular Rambo. He played the sniper.
Don't know, I've never seen Rambo.
What?
I've never seen Rambo.
You've never seen Rambo?
No, well, no, I've seen...
It's like the shortest film in the world, bro.
I think I've seen bits of First Blood and I've seen bits of First Blood, Second Blood.
I'm disgusted right now.
But that's about it. I haven't actually watched from beginning to end any kind of Rambo.
You know what? I'm going to put a list of films that you should see up on this board that we've got in the office. And
you know how I deal with notes.
Bro, it's not a note, it's a poster.
Oh, I'm just saying, it's just the poster's like a big note.
It's not a big note. It's a piece of paper with some...
What about this dude anyway?
I'm just saying, like, have you seen him in any other thing? But for when you haven't even seen Rambo, you wouldn't even know what the fuck I'm talking about. Yes. Redacted. The spiller of drinks.
It's empty, bruv. Come on.
Spiller of drinks.
It's empty.
It's freaking two episodes in a row, man.
Whoa, like, shit, man. If they get some cup holders up in this booth, like...
It's on the table. Just leave the shit on the table. Move away from the team. Speaking about moving away, Purge TV series.
Yeah, dumb. How can you have a TV series while they're still making movies of the damn thing? Number one. Number two, how are you going to have 10 episodes about one night? About one night a year? Fuck this TV series.
Yeah, I mean, like, I don't know. I mean, it's not the worst idea that we've had for a TV series. And it is a 10 episode event, so I assume it's just
event. One. Yeah, just because they put event at the end, that doesn't make it any more spectacular. Mm. It's a series. Like, just call it what it is. Yeah. It's a series.
Definitely. I mean, do we know of any of the cast? I think it's proper, like, Z-list, right?
It's probably nobody. It sounds bad, but literal nobody's. But the Purge is a stupid idea anyway. Like, just like, if you think about it practically, it's dumb. Like, just because you allow any type of crime on one night, it doesn't mean that you're not going to commit crimes on other nights.
Yeah.
And just because you've got crime on one night...
Doesn't mean that like, these other nights you're going
to
be...
Yeah, successful. How do you... Like, it's just extreme. It's extreme violence and extreme crime on one night that no one's accountable for. And, like, how do you... Who pays for that? Like, who is paying... Who's paying for the carnage in the morning?
I mean, the only thing I would say that would make more sense... Because the fucked up thing about The Purge, if you're thinking of it from a sort of, like, evolution point of view, all you're going to do is you're going to increase the amount of sadistic, fucked up people within society... And you're going to eliminate all the people that are not as equipped for this violence.
Yeah, that's something I didn't even really think about, but that is exactly true. Like, you are just going to end up with a country full of psychos.
Yeah. That pretend to be okay.
Yeah, they're going to... they're not going to. Like, it's going to get to a point where they're just going to start, you know, let's do Purge Eve.
Yeah.
Let's do Boxing Purge.
Yeah. let's have
New Purge Eve. Like, New Purge Day. Like, it's just gonna get crazy. Like, there's gonna have Thanks Purge.
Thanks Purge. or if it's like a
Easter Purge.
Yeah, they'll probably go full blown 40 days of purge, like, you know, for Lent.
Yeah.
Yeah. They'll do that.
Yeah. Exactly that.
Whatever days are longer. They'll do the killing.
Yeah. And it's just going to be all fucked up.
Yeah, I don't think it would be a good thing for society, as it were. Speaking about good things for society, there is this film starring Viggo Mortensen and Mahershala Ali.
Is that a good thing for society? Is that a good thing for society?
Well, yeah, the Green Book, because it's based on a turning point of history, if that makes sense. You're probably going to have to open up the other camera. So it's based on a turning point of history where poor white people and poor black people were sort of like...
I was thinking like... Oh, woe is me type poor. No, poor with no money.
As in, like, impoverished. Yeah. And then you've got this character, which is Dr. Green, I think it is.
Yeah.
Or Dr. Shirley or something like that. I can't remember.
Dr. Shirley?
Yeah, it sounded...
Green makes more sense, but I'm not sure if I heard that in the trailer.
Yeah, but, yeah, that guy...
I'm not a medical doctor.
He's not a medical doctor. He's a doctor in musician. He's a
doctor of music.
And, yeah, it's good. It looks fun.
Yeah.
It looks like one of those things that you would expect to see on an Oscar highlight reel.
Yeah, some smelling. Mm. I can smell Oscar in the air.
But...
Oscar's in the
one
air.
One thing I will say, now that they've changed this whole Oscar process, it probably won't go through.
How so?
As I said before, MOWOs, right? It's easy to predict what a typical Caucasian male of a certain age is going to appreciate in a film. It's harder to predict a mixed, eclectic audience and their perspective of what is a good film.
Disagree.
Been through this already. It's easier if it's the MOWOS, it's easy. MOWOS is movies of white origin, is it?
Yeah.
So yeah, when Oscars was the MOWOS, it's easier to predict. I knew what films were going to get Oscars, why they were going to get Oscars, the portrayals of the roles and all that stuff, if it was convincing. And it made sense. I mean, Philadelphia deserves an Oscar.
No. I mean, look.
Yes.
Yes to what you just said.
Yeah.
The last bit you said. No to the bit before that you just said.
As in, like... It was easier to predict before.
No. The only difference I think it's going to make is that, like, you'll get less... shit films that win Oscars.
I doubt it. I reckon yes. We'll seclude to the latter, because my version of a good film isn't necessarily Oscar worthy. I've got my own opinion of what a film, and then you've also got this new category that they've introduced, this popular film category and all that stuff.
That's bullshit.
And that's what I'm saying. It just feels like appeasement.
That is bullshit.
It doesn't feel like...
Well, it is. Like, that's the whole point. They want more people to watch the Oscars, and I guess that's kind of fair, but I don't know, do something else. Like, it's I don't know, you can't give a special award just to make people watch. Like, make the show more interesting.
Yeah.
Like,
a bit more.
If the show was more interesting, and I don't think it's just that people don't see films that they recognize is the reason why they don't watch it. They don't watch it because it's just a stuffy show with, like, people dressed up, sitting down, clapping at themselves for winning awards. Like,
and
if it was a little bit more...
And crying. And then when they don't win.
If it was a little bit more entertaining...
I mean, one thing I would say about the Oscars, like, if you were to sort of, like, improve it in some shape or form, I reckon there should be a year delay on the films that they nominate and all that stuff. Only reason why I say that is because all the films can be watched by the general public, and they can do something like an online vote as such, rather than, you know, the last 3 months before, you know. And then it makes a weird environment for actors as well, because you only see really good films at the end of the fucking year. And it's like a cop-out because they don't want any more competition, and they know how they have to raise the bar and shit.
No.
Yeah. Oscar season. Define Oscar season.
Yeah, but I mean, like, it's Oscar season because it's, like, basically the last chance to get your film in before the entry closes for that year. Mm-hmm. But it's more of a coincidence that turned into a thing. Like, I don't think people were like, you know, this is the section of the year where we're going to drop all the Oscar movies. It's like, gradually, it ended up being that time, because films that come out in January are eligible. You know, like, it's not like only films that come out in October can be in the Oscars. It's just, you know, it ends up being that way. Like, the summer is full of, big budget blockbuster movies. Like,
it never was the case before. I remember when the...
Yeah, but there's more of them now, so it is the case now.
I don't know.
Basically, from February to September, you got fucking, big budget movies coming out.
Yeah.
So, you know, obviously the smaller budget, more Oscar-y type movies...
Independence, that's what you call them. For the independence and foreign films.
Well, whatever, innit?
Slightly racist. But yeah, I mean, like, I get it. Don't get it twisted. I do get it. The main reason why I believe the Oscars does so well as a brand is because
because they're losing viewers every year.
Not really.
Yes, really, which is the whole point of having the popular film section. Like,
No. The main reason why I say not really is because
you're wrong.
No, because people don't watch the show, but they respect the results. They'll go and watch the Oscar-nominated films in the cinema because there is...
No, some people, but like, most people won't.
Most people don't.
No, they don't, because those films don't... It's not like they don't make as much money as, like, not even, you know... Like, there's no real comparison in the amount of money that they make. Like... The average moviegoer does not go out and seek out Oscar movies after the Oscars are done.
Well, they used to. They don't do it anymore, but they used
to. Well, most of the time, those films aren't in the cinema anyway. Mm-hmm. Like, by the time the Oscars come out, like, those films are past. Like, it's too late. Like, they're not in the cinemas anymore.
Mm. And I know some films have actually been re-added. I know that Moonlight was actually re-added after the one of, was it a couple of Oscars?
Yeah, some they do, but they don't do that for everything.
But yeah, I mean, like, speaking about online debates, and online, as it were, Star Wars new streaming live action thingy. I mean, I've got a little bit more information about it this week, so it's a case of, like, it's about 10 million an episode. What's the cast saying? Do you know anything about the cast, or is it just like they're just going to use the existing people in the, I mean, if they're charging 10 million an episode, I suppose.
I don't think, as far as I know, I haven't heard anything about cast, but it's going to be all new characters. They're not using existing characters. Like, those are for movies, isn't it? They're not going to...
Yeah, but it's like pretty much a movie budget. This is what confusing me.
Yeah, but then, like, so is Game of Thrones. Like, you don't, you know, they're not, you know, just because you're using a high budget on a TV series doesn't mean you need to use the same cast that you have in the films.
And it doesn't mean that you have to wait 4 fucking years for the next series to come out. I'm so angry about Game of Thrones. You shouldn't have reminded me, bruv. You know how long it's been?
It happens, isn't it?
You know how long it's been? Do you know how long it's been?
Yeah, but like, we knew this was the case. It's not like you weren't pre-warned. It's not like they all like set you up and they were like, oh well, you know, maybe we're coming back in like 6 months to a year or whatever, and it's like, oh shit, you know, you gotta wait like 2 years.
It's like 3 years, bro.
Whatever, look at that. Like, you were pre-warned.
Already. It's been 2 years already, bro.
You were pre-warned.
It's terrible.
It's not that bad.
And speaking about terrible online practices.
What, Venom? Again.
Oh, God, no. You just want me to say it. You're a bad guy. Grant Gustin. Yeah. GG. Grant Gustin and Ruby Rose.
Yeah, Ruby Rose.
They sound like freaking Marvel characters with their normal names. That's weird. Those guys are getting bullied online. If you're one of them people, stop it.
You who bully the most people, you're going to tell people to stop bullying people online?
I know people that deserve it. Like, Ruby Rose isn't even famous enough to get bullied. And freaking, it's the stuff they're saying to them is getting me angry. Like, was it Grant? He's too skinny. He's always been skinny. And, who else?
Some people just discovered it.
And Ruby Rose, or Rose Ruby, or whatever.
It's Ruby Rose.
She apparently isn't gay enough to play a lesbian, despite being a real lesbian in her own life. How lesbian do you have to be Batwoman?
Super lesbian.
No, it's like two of them. It's like four. There's four Batwomen, for what I remember. There's the time where like one of them got injured, and they got replaced. There's another one where another one died. It's all very complicated. I mean, I've been reading through like Batwoman because obviously people have been because people are saying, Shun, you're being an arsehole, and I do get it, but realistically,
yeah,
it's true. Like,
what, that you are an asshole?
I am an asshole. But, you know, in regards to sort of like Batwoman, she isn't the most interesting Bat character within the family. If you're talking about the whole family.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean she can't be interested. Like, just because she's not the most interesting, that doesn't mean you ignore her completely.
That, and as I said before, it's not necessary.
What, Batwoman?
Yeah, she's not necessary.
She is what necessary.
No. What is necessary within...
Gotham needs a hero.
Arrowverse needs a Batman.
Arrowverse can't get a Batman.
Arrowverse can get a Batwoman.
Yeah.
Get a Batman.
No, they can't get a Batman.
They can. Now they can. Gotham's dead.
No bueno. Yeah, but like...
Gotham is dead.
Yeah, but he wasn't Batman. He was just kid Bruce Wayne. Like, they will not allow two Batmen to be walking the earth at the same time.
But two jokes is his phone.
They don't care about it. Yeah, fine. It's one Joker. Like, they're not going to make that second Joker movie.
It's two Jokers.
They're not going to make that second
there's
Joker
two Jokers movie. At this point in time in continuity.
Well, no. Technically, there's one. Because the other film hasn't come out.
And it's in the Dark Universe.
Yeah. You know about the Bat Embargo. They're not going to allow that shit.
Pointless embargo, bro.
They're not going to allow that shit. They're worried about watering down the brand.
Because keeping it strong and, you know, undiluted is working for them.
Well, you know, like, it could be worse.
I don't think it can.
It could be worse.
I don't think it can. I mean...
You could have two shit Batmen.
And two shit Jokers.
Exactly.
That's probably what's going to happen. Exactly. Eco Warrior. The fucking Warrior Eco. It's sort of like a featurette sort of section I thought I'd bring to the table because we're both big fans of The Raid and films as such as that. What's your favourite scene in the first Raid and the second Raid?
When he goes through the floor.
Yeah, that's my favourite scene as well. He shoots through the floor.
And then when he fucks up the people in the prison yard. Oh, no, maybe it's the... when he fucks up the people in the toilet.
Yeah, that's pretty hardcore. But
is that it's one of those
one?
Two.
The first one, yeah?
No, the second one.
Second one?
Yeah.
My favourite one's the Hammer and the Batgirl. The Hammer Girl and the Bat Guy in the corridor for the second one.
Yeah.
For the first one, I don't know, I mean... The last boss battle was pretty intense, I think.
Mm-hmm.
What I remember. I remember the first raid last boss battle being epic. The second... Actually, no. See, there's a lot of scenes in the second one I love.
Yeah. It's a great movie.
Yeah, it's a lot. I mean, Gareth Evans actually did quite a good job on sort of like just reinventing that whole brutal Asian cinema for a British palette. Or American Western palette, would I say?
Is it?
West...
Do you think it is?
Yeah, it feels more Western than other Asian films.
Maybe, but it doesn't feel... It doesn't feel so Western. Like, it's... It doesn't feel... I don't know. I don't think it is.
I don't think it feels... It doesn't, for me, feel... I don't know about it, because John Woo... I know you hate John Woo.
I don't hate John Woo. I just hate Mission Impossible 2. It's garbage. It is garbage. It's universally known as garbage.
Lead as it may, it actually sold more than Mission Impossible 3, it did.
Yeah, but that was only off hype. Like, it's not you know, more critically acclaimed, or you know, it's not held in a higher regard. It just made more money. And 3 only made less money because people remembered how shit 2 was.
Number 2 is the better film.
It's not. It isn't. What? Because it made more money.
It made more money, or made the money back.
Yeah, but it doesn't make it better.
Yeah, it does.
No, it doesn't.
It does.
No, it just means it made more money.
Right. We'll agree to disagree on that moment. So, Eco anyway.
Yeah, because it's garbage.
So, they're touting Gareth Evans as the next John Woo, or the new John Woo for this generation, because obviously he's now sparked off like chain reactions within the world of John Wick and all that stuff, because a lot of people say that John Wick has helped Hollywood sort of like transition the action genre. I believe it was The Raid that basically introduced the whole wide shot and the suffering of the character within the shot. So for example, usually we'll have effortless
John
battles.
Wick doesn't suffer.
Huh?
John Wick doesn't suffer.
Well, he gets fucked up.
Oh, really?
Well, not as much as he should, but...
Not really at all.
Maybe I'm thinking of Daredevil. Daredevil's that scene where he's sort of like, he's physically exhausted, more like Old Boy, so... But I mean, glass are sort of like shots like that anyway, because like, there's a lot of sort of scenes where he does get mashed up. He does get mashed up properly, but, you know, the wide angle makes you see all of the image.
Yeah.
So, yeah, but in regards to The Raid and Eco's work within The Raid, yeah, it kind of like put that sort of style of cinema back on the map, because obviously it's only been kind of like seen in one aspect, which was Old Boy before.
Yeah.
I mean, in my knowledge anyway, of that era of cinema anyway. And then The Raid made a whole film off that awkward feel of violence. Mm. So it wasn't sort of like straightforward, like pow, straight to the face, you go on the floor, you die now, sort of thing. Violence. It's more like, I'm going to hit you really hard, you're going to hit me really hard, we're going to keep hitting each other until we're tired, and then I'm going to wait for you to sort of like really be tired, and I'm going to cut your throat with a hook blade, which he was trying to kill me with.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
That's
the new term of violence. So yeah, I mean, salute to Eco. Gareth Evans is actually doing a new project called Apostle. Trying to sort of like look at sort of some form of like trailer just to get a feel of it, but it's coming on Netflix and it's going to be out on October the 12th, so
this year,
so something to look forward to or to look at. Another film that's come out, which probably slipped under a lot of people's radars, is surprise surprise, Mr. John Wick, and it's Manhunt. And it's not what you think. It's not the video game Manhunt. It's like a film called Manhunt.
Okay.
I've only seen a couple clips and trailers of it. It looks interesting enough. Very John Woo. There's a couple doves somewhere.
How John Woo?
I don't know. I haven't seen all of it.
Is
so.
It the most John Woo John Woo's ever John Woo'd in his John Woo life?
No. It's probably just like John Woo.
Good.
John Woo post 50.
Because no one wants to see that again.
Yeah, they do.
No, they don't.
I want John Woo to have a movie about a fighting dove with guns.
You're just saying that Mission Impossible shit to just to annoy me.
You reckon?
Yes. No, yes, I do.
I'm not that cerebral.
Yes, you are.
If I really wanted to piss you off, I would say that Tasmania is the best theme tune.
You know that's not true.
It is.
No.
Okay, so which theme tune is better than Tasmania?
All of them.
What do you mean all of them?
Every theme tune is better than Tasmania.
That is ridiculous.
It's not ridiculous.
No, because before you was like, oh, Animaniacs, they have Chow Mein in their lyrics and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And yeah, so I thought, all right, then I'll challenge you. And I'm pretty sure that was the Simpson bit that they had at the end.
Yeah, fine. You was right this one time.
Mm. Yeah. Let's just give everybody at home like sort of like the synopsis, right? So, a theme tune back in the day for any form of cartoon is to basically say all of the characters in the show, the premise of the show, and the ideology of the characters. So, what they're about. So, who, the what, and the why, right? Now, my opinion, Tasmania does a better job of doing that.
No, it doesn't, because you can't even understand what the guy's saying.
Yeah, you can.
Barely.
You can.
Barely.
It's all jingle jangles. Like, it's very, 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 you know, yokel.
Yeah, no one wants to hear that yokel Australian shit.
Oof. Do you take that back, sir?
Never.
Take that back?
Never.
Take it back.
Wylion, bruv.
Oof. So, in regards to your Animaniacs...
Animaniacs is way better.
It's not.
It is. It is.
About the same.
No, it's not about the same. It's way better. Oh. They ticked all the boxes.
I mean, the good news is for you,
yeah,
is that Animaniacs is actually getting two new seasons on Hulu. It's been like, commissioned.
I ain't got no Hulu.
Well, it'll probably come out of here on Amazon. Or maybe Now TV. Definitely Now TV. But you'll be paying that dollar bill. Bloody dollar. So, it's terrible stuff.
Is it? I mean, yeah, it's. It is. Yeah, things get control on that shit.
I mean, but the one theme tune that beats all of those, which I reckon we will all agree on, is Inspector Gadget.
Yes.
Because everything within that theme tune and that VT or that title sequence.
Yeah, but then that it goes against everything you just said because it doesn't tell you the characters.
It does.
No, it doesn't.
It does.
It doesn't tell you the characters. You see the characters.
You see the
but
characters.
But that's not the theme tune.
No, but that's what you need to know. Like, da 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 are the kids. Or the kid and the dog. And then da 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 Inspector Gadget.
Yeah, one character. One character gets named in that theme song.
Exactly, but it makes more sense because it's all done on
beat. It doesn't. It's
all done on beat.
I mean, it makes sense because it's a dope tune, but it doesn't make sense to what, like, the where, the what, and the why what you was talking about because okay, none of those are in there, but it's still awesome.
Okay, so I would say either Count Duckula or Trapdoor have the perfect opening sequence to theme tune ratio. Or, even better than that, Danger Mouse.
Yes.
It's a bit dramatic, but everything's done.
Yes. Yeah, when I was younger, I wanted to be a spy that lives in a letterbox.
That's weird.
He had a dope-ass car.
Yeah, he did. That car was sick. But yeah, trying to think. There was a couple more issues. So basically, a little update on the whole Guardians and sort of like 2 and below debate. What we're going to be doing soon-ish is that we're going to be compiling really bad films against Redacted's wishes because he's the one that came up with the idea. And we're going to be doing a series of...
I wouldn't come up with an idea so diabolical.
It's horrible, but yes, it was you. And it's gonna be 2 and below. So anything that's on Netflix or Prime that's 2 and below, we're gonna be reviewing, much against our will. We're gonna try and do a sort of like live reaction video as well, so when we're watching it, you can feel the pain as well. Yeah, it's going to be interesting. Say live reaction, it's probably just going to be us shouting over the... Yeah, because Redacted doesn't like to have his face shown.
It's going to be myself poking my eyes out.
Mm, definitely. Yeah, it should be good. So you've got... So you've got two and below, and you've also got the review show, which we're going to be kicking into gear, hopefully, around episode 30, I would say. What do you reckon?
Maybe.
Yeah, so there'll be a lot more things out then, so.
I think the opposite, actually.
No, because yeah. At the moment, all we've got at the moment is, what, Mile 22, which we will be reviewing. I want to watch that film in the cinema. Mark Wahlberg, Ico, some other violent people. It's going to be good. I mean, Onback was the only... Well, not even Onback. Tony Jaa was like the only one for a while that kind of like perked the interest of the action community. But I think Ico, he's very, very on point, if that makes sense. And he will be really, really good for... the future of martial arts within film until the robots take over anyway. Have you seen that YouTube clip of the Disney robots?
Nope.
It's peak, bro. Basically, they've got robots doing acrobatics.
Okay.
Acrobatic robots. And they're going to be using them in Disney World. And I reckon they're going to replace stuntmen.
Okay.
It's going to be peak, bro. But it's safer. But then, you know, it means that actors have to start acting. So
it's their job.
Yeah, but shout out to Gal Gadot.
Gal Gadot's fucked.
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh yeah. Gal Gadot in she's gonna be in Ralph Breaks the Internet.
Ugh. Who's she playing?
Huh?
Who's she playing?
I don't know. I have no idea. But
you know, I'd be really fucked up if Disney get her to play Wonder Woman.
What do you mean?
Because you know, like Wreck-It Ralph and all that stuff has loads of sort of like cameos and all that stuff from game characters and all that stuff.
Yeah, well, Wonder Woman's not a game character.
Yeah, but she's like a DC character. That could
yeah, but they don't have DC characters in Wreck-It Ralph.
They didn't really touch on comic book characters, did they? Just mainly went game for video games.
Yeah.
But yeah, this is what it could be, so...
Yeah, we might actually see what Gal Gadot looks like with some expression on her face.
Oof! Do you reckon that they're just going to, like, improvise...
What, a smile on her face? Yeah.
It's going to look creepy.
Yeah.
Actually, no, she could smile. She could smile.
Yeah, that's one of her two facial expressions.
Smile and...
What was it? Frown.
Smile and frown.
Yeah, like a frowny... stare, like
stoic,
sort of angry but like holding in a fart.
Yeah, I kind of get that as well.
That's her two expressions.
You know what, I reckon, like,
if you don't believe me, just watch Wonder Woman again, or watch anything. Anything she's in again.
I reckon what they should do is that they should have Gal Gadot do the motion capture and just have Nigella.
What's the point?
No, and then get Nigella Lawson to do the motion capture for the face, because their faces are quite similar.
No, they're not.
Yeah. Well, Nigella Lawson can actually, you know, smile and convey emotion.
Yeah.
And she's a real human being. But yeah, on that swift note, I'm going to wrap this one up. But there are a couple announcements that I have to make.
You just did.
No, there's more. If you have kept on this long on the podcast... please make sure you subscribe to all the initial channels. So, you know, the Twitter, the Facebook, the YouTube, the Podbean, the Mixcloud, there's a couple more things. But there'll be a description below, so anything that's in the description box below, please look at it, because it takes us a while to type it out, especially because I can't read. Thank you for your time, and yeah. Real Dumb Shit, Wylion.
Goodbye.